And if you're sneezing and wheezing, then you know it's allergy season. We have a specialist from the Ogden Clinic telling us how to fight back.
This is Fox 13's The Place.
But first, it's allergy season, and mold and pollen can make you miserable. If you suffer from allergies, we'll find out from the Ogden Clinic how you can win the battle. Stay with us. The Place will be right back.
Welcome back, everyone. Hey, it's allergy season. Are you suffering or anybody in your family and you need some help? So glad to have Dr. Bryan Wilcox here from Ogden Clinic talking about the different seasonal allergies that are happening now. What should we be looking for?
Well, right now it's tree pollen season. So allergies are both year-round and seasonal. And as of the last few weeks, tree pollens have become prevalent. And in the springtime, we have tree pollens, in the summertime, grass pollens, and in the late summer and fall, weed pollens. So that is on top of the year-round allergies that you'll get from the indoor allergens like molds and dust mites and pet dander.
Can people just develop allergies as they age, or is it something you're born with?
You can. Often there's a family history, and so children will develop it young in life. But I've had people in their 70s develop allergies just out of the blue and never had them before.
Wow. Okay, so the tree pollen allergies you're talking about right now, that will last until the summer months?
May or June.
Okay, so when the leaves and everything is all done blooming out. Okay, and what can people take? What's an over-the-counter thing that they can take that kind of give them some relief?
Well, the most common thing are antihistamines. Zyrtec, Allegra, Claritin, Benadryl, most people are familiar with. I'm kind of surprised to see that there are a lot of people that just deal with their allergies and don't take anything for them, and it's quite easy to treat them once you know what to do with or how to treat them. And so the antihistamines are kind of the first line, so take your pick. You only need one of them. The most common mistake I see is that people will take multiple antihistamines, and that only adds to the side effect profile.
Gosh, they just want to get to feeling better quickly, right?
So if Zyrtec doesn't work, they take Zyrtec and Allegra, but you only want to take one of them. Zyrtec and Allegra tend to be effective but minimally sedating. But then if that doesn't control your symptoms, add a nasal steroid spray like Flonase or Nasacort. They're also over-the-counter. So those two medicines in combination target allergy from two different angles, if you will, and are effective. And that'll take care of allergy for probably 90% of people.
Wow. Okay, so we kind of skipped over some symptoms. Can you just go through a little bit? Because I think sometimes people think, I have allergies if my eyes water or, you know, if my nose is running.
Yeah, and those are the two.
There you have it. I won! Yeah.
So itchy nose, sneezing, runny nose, congestion, itchy, watery eyes, those are the most common.
Everything is in the head, right?
Yeah. Okay. Typically, well, not always. It can be rash.
Okay.
But most commonly in the nose and eyes.
What about babies with allergies?
Well, babies typically don't get allergies. So until about 2 or 3 years of age, it's usually not allergy. Babies, however, can get eczema, which is an allergy in the skin, usually a rash on the flexor surfaces. And that can progress to allergic rhinitis, and then that can progress to asthma. There's actually something called the allergic march, where kids will go from eczema to allergy to asthma. And if you can identify and treat allergy early in life, there's actually data to show that you can prevent the formation of asthma, which helps with quality of life down the road.
Okay, so with these babies, is there anything that parents can do with food or formula to kind of help combat that?
Well, food allergy is a whole other topic.
Oh.
That's
we'll
a realm that is very expansive, so that would have to be dealt with on another day. Food allergy often will cause true allergy, such as peanut allergy, where you can actually die from anaphylaxis. Most food allergy, however, is food sensitivity and isn't true allergy.
So. What's the immunotherapy system about?
So when you identify allergy, you can do three things. You can avoid what you're allergic to. You can take medicines, which don't stop the allergy. It masks the symptoms after you've had the allergy. Or you can do immunotherapy, which is changing your immune system so you don't have the reaction in the first place. So it's the most effective form of therapy, either delivered in the form of allergy shots, most people are familiar with shots, or sublingual drops. So you can deliver small amounts of antigen either by drops under the tongue or shots in the arm after you find out what you're allergic to, and then start with small doses, incrementally enlarging, and your body develops a tolerance to those things. So it actually prevents your immune system from overreacting. It changes the way your body sees those pollens and allergens.
Wow, real quick, is it true that you can be too sanitized?
So there's a phenomenon that purports that if you're too clean, you actually make your body conditioned to allergy. It's called the hygiene hypothesis. Westernized cultures have a 20% incidence of allergy, whereas developing nations only a 3% because they're exposed to more dirt. And so if you are constantly washing with hand sanitizer or antimicrobial soaps, you're actually making your immune system more allergy prevalent.
Wow. So maybe after holding those chicks, I shouldn't have washed my hands.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, for the mothers that their child's pacifier falls on the ground, I say just put it back in the mouth.
You heard Dr. Wilcox say that.
Or expose your kids to goats and chickens and pets and, you know, expose them to dirt, and they'll actually be less prone to allergy.
Wow. So many things to learn about. Allergy season is what we're talking about. You can go to Ogden Clinic. You can go to your website, which is OgdenClinic.com. Or don't forget, there's always our website at Fox13Now.com. Click on the place. Thanks so much.
You're
welcome. I know a lot of people out there going, that's what I'm going to do. Hey, coming up next.